Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome back for another Total War guide video with the Terminator. So with all the medieval style strategy games I've been spotlighting lately, I got really nostalgic for the time and decided to load up Medieval 2 Total War and have a go at the old Crusader Kingdoms and conquer the known world medieval style. But what immediately struck me was the dated graphics of Medieval 2. It's not bad, don't get me wrong, I'd be happy to play it as it is, but I wanted to give graphic enhancements a shot with this game and see how good I can make it. After a few different tries, I think I've got it just right. So in this video, I'll be running you, dear viewer, through a set of instructions to make Medieval 2 Total War look as good as possible. Let's get started. So first off, whether you enjoy vanilla Medieval 2 or not, you have to try the amazing mod, Stainless Steel. It's basically Medieval 2 Total War Plus. I mean, if you're gonna go through the effort of making the game look good, you might as well make it play insanely good as well. It comes with a range of new content, a much bigger map, enhanced AI behavior, and of course, some upgraded graphics, which is why I'm recommending it here. So if you haven't played Stainless Steel before, I'm gonna take you through a really quick installation guide to the mod. First, you wanna go on ModDB, link is in the description of this video, and go on to the 6.4 section and hit the download button. This will give you the base 6.3 version of the mod and 6.4, which is the most up-to-date patch. Next, you wanna unzip it and place the folder in your Medieval 2 common folder, which you can find in the directory on your screen now. Once there, run the 6.3 setup, then run 6.4 to install in the same game folder. Finally, you set up what submods you want and you're good to go. Two tips here for running the mod. If you get an error saying Kingdoms is missing, all you need to do is copy paste your medieval launch file in the same folder and rename it Kingdoms. That will 100% resolve the issue. And second, always run using the Stainless Steel launch file. Don't launch Medieval 2 from Steam. To make it easier, go into Steam, hit the Games tab at the top, and press Add a non-Steam game to your library. Then find and add the 6.4 launcher, so whenever you want to play, you can just launch the game in Steam. Stainless Steel comes with loads of graphics modifications, including enhanced graphics textures, lighting, shading, loads of new models, so it's pretty damn good. Next, we want to download and use Reshade, a graphics enhancement program that gives you the tools you need to play around with any aspect of the game. I mainly use it for shading, contrast, sharpness, and color saturation, so that's what we're going to use today. So we need to install it first, and to do that you need to go on the website, which again you can find in the video description, and scroll to the bottom of the page until you see that download button and hit it. Once the program is downloaded, you need to run the Reshade setup program and select a game you want to use the application for. So go in there and select Medieval 2. Then, because it runs on DirectX 9, you want to select the first option here. This will take you to a screen with lots of unchecked boxes as seen now. You want to check all of those and hit OK. With that, Reshade will download all the files you've checked off, giving you essentially all the tools available to enhance your in-game graphics. Now all we need to do is go into the game and start playing around with these settings. So I've personally been working on a preset myself that includes all the settings you see on your screen now. If you can't be bothered to play around with settings on Reshade to get the picture that you want, then you can download my preset from the Google Drive link in the description of this video. The settings here are good for both campaign and battle modes of the game, so no worries there, and it really makes a massive difference. Overall, you get a lot more sharpness to the game while keeping some level of blur. You've got a lot more color and saturation to bring the game to life a bit, but you also have a bit more of a darker atmosphere. This is the medieval times after all. I wanted to make the contrast and shadows a bit more pronounced to give it a darker feel because, to be honest, I just felt like vanilla was a bit too bright, and medieval is, it's a dark time, you know? So I think the kind of picture that I have here better represents the time and gives me a better feel for a medieval atmosphere. So there you have it, Medieval 2 is completely different now. Much sleeker, sharper, and colorful, but also retaining a really nice dark tone to the overall picture. Much nicer compared to vanilla. As I said guys, you can have a play around with these Reshade settings yourself or with the brightness setting in game to get what you want, but my recommendation would be to stick to this. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If you did, give it a like and drop any thoughts or questions in the comments section below. And if there's anything you're confused by or you need some help with, just drop a comment below. I'm usually really, really responsive. I'll get right back to you. Don't forget to subscribe for more Total War content, gameplay, and news. I make 5 videos a week, so lots more to come. And of course, if you have any requests, just drop those in the comments as well. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.